And social media doesn't help that on occasions.
Well, I think there's, I mean, it's social media is a double-edged sword. It can add, you know, it can be supportive and it can be, it can show you up or you, it's also about what you look for. You know, if all that you're seeing and your filters are all about seeing what other people do well that you don't, that's going to be a problem. You know, if you filter that out and you focus on the support, then, you know, that's great too. I find for our students that are studying distance learning, you know, and they're not in a class, that sense of community is lost. You know, you're not sitting next to someone going, I suck at this. Do you suck at this as well? Is this normal? Am I normal? Do I, you know, am I especially stupid? And this is going well. And how do you feel about this? That's really important. And social media has replaced that.
Yeah.
And I think that's really valuable. You know, when you find a community that supports you and says, you know, we're all struggling together, but let's keep doing this. You know, not the negative, everything's crap and complaining about everything and toxic, but that it's created that community. And I studied, you know, distance learning as well. So, and that was before social media.
But I have had a client, Yvonne, that has come up to me and said, James, I'm so deflated because I see my friends on Facebook or whatever saying, I graduated here or I passed here. And I only had to say one sentence to that client. It was, run your own race.
Totally.
That's totally all you have to do is run your own race. So comparison, if anyone's either comparing to their friends regarding accounting exams, stop it and run your own race.
Totally. You need to be better than you were yesterday.
Completely.
You know, you need, the only person you need to compare to is yourself, because you don't see everything else. You know, you don't see the challenges that they have in life. You don't see the resources that they may have had that you don't. You don't see their strengths and weaknesses. But we have a tendency as humans to only compare to the people ahead of us.
Yeah, completely.
So we have a tendency to go, well, you have that and I don't, and therefore I don't like that and I'm not happy or that makes me feel bad. And I say to a lot of my students, and I actually wrote a post on my blog about this, is, you know, how many thousands of students and people are behind you that would give anything to be where you are?
Correct.
You know, I mean, if we think of the statistics in the world of how few people are ever going to be able to have any kind of tertiary education or even finish school.
Never mind have a credible professional qualification.
Absolutely. Never mind any level of any tertiary education. You know, if you have any level of tertiary education, you're technically ahead of millions of people in the world, but we don't see that. You know, we don't really acknowledge that. We just look and go, well, I don't have the degree. I don't have the postgrad. I don't have the yet. You know, I'm working towards it, but I don't have it. And then when you get it, you focus forward again. And when you get that, the goalposts keep moving.